Hi Nick, I thank you very much for being on Pure Channel. It's a pleasure to talk to you about the record Soul is Heavy that will be released the 26th of September in France. My first question about this record was to know if you think it's a much more soul record than the previous one.
From the energy, it's the same. It's heartfelt, it's passion. It's me, it's emotional, it's pure, it's the way I am. It's not like I was focused on doing something different this time around, making it sound more blues or soul or, you know, I don't know. That's not the intention.
It's a complicated question for the musicians, but how would you describe that very unique mix you're doing in your music?
I would consider my music as sort of a combination of all sorts of sounds: rock, afrobeat, reggae, eclectic sounds, you know, just a mix of Western and African elements.
Is it your taste in music that is very large?
No, I think it has a lot to do with the way I feel, you know. So it's almost like colors, you know. If you feel attracted to yellow, or you're feeling like blue today, or tomorrow it's green. So that is how my music is. It's very colorful, and I create music according to how my day goes, or how I feel that very point in time. It has a lot to do with my emotions and my state of mind. You know, if I'm balanced, or if I feel I'm worried, or if I'm having a battle, all that I eventually convey through my music.
Because listening to the record, I had the sensation you were describing a very hard word, you know, very, very hard word, but always with the hope behind, always with the love feelings coming in. Although you're very clear on what could be hard in this life, you know, for there's always hope behind. Would you say it's a link in your lyrics? This,
yeah, that's exactly what I'm trying to. That's the message I'm trying to get across. You know, that no matter how difficult or whatever difficulties you may be going through in life, you know, at the end of the day, the opposite would always have to come to pass, you know. And it also has a lot to do with the way you channel your energy. Energy is very important. How you take the energy in around you, and what you do with the energy inside of you, and, you know, how you at the end of the day also reproduce the energy. The way we see things is the way we see things. There's no other dimension right now that we can imagine of seeing things. There could be a different dimension, but we're not able to see because we have been taught to see things the way we see things, you know. But from the way we you know, perceive things, hope is definitely a necessary element of our survival of existence.
To put the energy the way you want, with the strength you want, do you have some tricks in recording or in production so it could be smooth?
Well, it varies. It varies, you know. It all depends on what kind of idea you have, and then also depends on when you create the song. If you've already created a song and you want the band, for instance, to play what you've already composed, then you know, it all depends on how you are making music. If you're making a song from scratch with the band, obviously it's easier with the emotions, to get the emotions across.
You considered, I've read many articles where you considered as a very politically engaged artist. First, do you agree with that? And do you think it's right, or is just the sincerity of your lyrics and the way that you seem to be looking around you, the world moving?
I think that's exactly the point, that I'm more a person who, you know, I perceive what's happening around me. I take in, I speak, I feel, you know, I see what many are going through, and I feel sort of, you know, connected, and therefore, in other words, responsible to be a voice to over many, you know, and I educate myself, definitely, but I wouldn't consider myself as, I would never be a politician, for instance, you know. I could be sort of an activist in a way, but what kind of activist? I'm more of a love activist than a political activist.
There are two people playing with you, two featurings on that record. I wanted to know, how did you get to make those songs together with Black Thought and Miss Dynamite? How did you meet, and how did you arrive to the point that you said, oh, I want to sing with them on my record?
We toured with The Roots a couple of times, and they've been very supportive. I love Black Thought's energy. He's very real, very strong, and very not fake. And when I heard the track, after I finished producing the track, God knows why, I thought there was definitely a necessity to put a man in between, you know. And I thought of Black Thought. There was no other person there. It was no second thought. It was Black Thought. And it fit. As for Miss Dynamite, I've always loved her stuff. I've always followed her career. You know, when I was not making music, she was out there already, you know, doing her thing. And I was always very motivated when I saw her, you know. We met. She came to my concert. And we connected through a friend. So, we know each other. And, the track Sleep was also one where I heard, when I heard the rhythm of the track, of the beat, I felt this has to be Dynamite, you know. And then I approached her. First, she didn't have time. So I was thinking, oh, it wouldn't even work out. But then eventually, she made some time, and it's really great to have her on the record. Definitely.
Well, thank you very much. You've been supported. You mentioned Nas and Damien Marley tour. You also played with Kravitz, Nas Barkley. You've been supported by very talented musician along your career, and I hope the viewers will support you too by buying legally the record Soul is Heavy, the 26th of September. Thank you very much.